Hello everyone, this is Majestic and I will be starting to play the Game of Thrones episode 5. So here we go! This is my first time recording a gameplay, so bear with me. This is my first time. I won't be talking that much during the video, so here we go. So if you're expecting some guy being talking a lot during the gameplay, I won't be that guy. I'm just going to talk a little bit here in the beginning, then we start the game. Alright, I've been playing this game a while now, so I started to play on episode 5. I've been already played all the 4 episodes, so this one is going to be a continuation on the episode 5s. I might someday record the other episodes and do them in like a series, but I don't know about that. So let's see, maybe with the season 2. Alright, here we go. And there we go with episode 5.
Previously on Game of Thrones. You'd help the Second Sons, guide them into Meereen.
I can't, Asha.
This could be our only chance.
Get them into the city, help them liberate Meereen, and I will see that you are rewarded.
You think you can reason with a wardling?
No, I'm a friend.
Don't move.
This is my sister, Sylvie.
I have to get in there, Sarah. Lord Whitehill is up to something. He's conspiring against my family, and someone in there is helping him.
Andros is hiring sellswords. Hundreds of them.
What?
He's building an army for Lord Whitehill, big enough to march against Ironwrath.
Talia, I may be leaving you here with a traitor.
Find out who it is.
Rodri!
I'm told you're a man who can't be broken.
I've decided to come see for myself. I was just telling your sister. Father's been looking to make a match for me. And Talia's been such good company. Think she likes me? Or maybe your mother? A flower plucked is still a flower. Just dies more quickly. We could be a family, Lord Forrester. You'd like that, wouldn't you? Your mother may need some convincing.
It'd be a privilege to call you family.
You hear that, Talia? Father will be so pleased. But let's put our happy day to the side for a moment. Walk with me. Oh. You won't need your sword. Not where we're going.
Very well.
That was easy. There. Doesn't that feel better? Oh, you're coming too.
This is Lord's business, not a child's.
I say she comes. I don't trust her with my men.
Better with him than those motherfucking guards. If I know the Game of Thrones world, everybody rapes everybody. And I don't trust this motherfucker either.
How fares your father, Lord Bolton?
Better than yours. Polite of you to ask. I loved playing in the woods when I was your age. Still do? So many places to hide. I've gotten very good at finding people.
Roderick?
It's all right, Talia.
That reminds me. Where's Griff? I expected to be greeted by him on my arrival. Bit of a disappointment to have to show myself in.
And here I had such high hopes for Ludson.
Griff was injured. The Maester is looking after him.
I'm aware of Griff's injuries, and that you inflicted them. Oh, I really hoped things might be different with you. I hoped we could be friends. After all, I was generous. I've allowed you to keep half your forest, your livelihood. Yet you went behind my back and called in the Glenmores. I'm not sure how you managed that. The Glenmores have sworn their loyalty to my father.
Lady Elena Glenmore is our guest. The soldiers accompanied her to ensure her safety.
If her safety is a concern, perhaps she should not have come to Ironwrath. Well, I'm certainly glad we've sorted this out. Thank you for being so forthcoming. But there's still a price. Ah. Here we are.
Arthur! Roderick!
You disobeyed me. You disrespected me. Someone has to pay! You didn't think it would be you. Your damaged goods. Someone else's leftovers.
Arthur's done nothing wrong! If you want to hurt someone, hurt me!
No, Roderick!
Why bother? You're nearly a corpse already.
No! Stop!
Look at what you've done! I hope it was worth it.
Is it worth it, Arthur?
Please!
Talia, don't look away.
No!
It's very important you see what comes of disobedience.
Roderick! Make him stop!
Talia, don't look.
Please.
Look at him, Talia. See what your brother's done.
Please, Lord Ramsay.
Sorry, but they'll never learn otherwise.
Mercy, have mercy! Mercy, my lord!
Did Roderick show mercy to Griff? This is his fault. That's a lot of blood.
Fuck you, Rus.
I'll see you dead for this!
And that, Talia, is why no one likes your brother.
Dude, nobody likes you either.
The poor lad's fainted. Let's give him a minute. You want to kill me, don't you?
Yep.
Release him.
I'll fuck you up, boy. That's what I'm gonna do.
Go on. Prove how strong you are. Do it for Ethan.
No, Roderick. He's toying with you.
Fuck it.
Come Worth on, it. Roderick. I'm impressed.
Woo.
Lucky for me, you're a cripple. I may have misjudged you, Roderick. I came here to kill you. But now, I'm thinking. It might be far more entertaining to watch you and Lud tear each other to pieces. I never want to come back to this fucking shit stain of a holdfast. I have better things to do than to play wet nurse to you and Lud. So you'll settle this on your own. Last house standing wins. Otherwise, I'll kill you both and be done with it.
House Forrester will win this fight.
You're very confident for a man with no army and half a face. And one more thing.
Oh, shit.
Can't leave a job half finished. Ready the horses. Not sure you'll have much luck finding other allies.
Well, that was a little bit disheartening. Damn it! Well, I've been hoping that Bruce Bolton gets his fucking ending in the season 6, I hope. So we can see his ass get ripped apart. But I really hate that character. Not as much as Joffrey, but be more satisfying to see him die compared to Joffrey. Joffrey was a dick, but who cares? But this dude, he fucked Sansa, fucking raped her, and that's something I don't forget. Well, man. So, let you get it next season. I'm actually hoping to see something really cool in season 6. See what happens. Find any clues or shit on this one?
Only a monster would do such a thing.
Yep, and his name
Bolton's
is Bolton's
will pay for this. Innocent blood shed on Forrester lands. What would Father think?
I keep asking myself what we've done to deserve such hate. Did we bring it on ourselves? Or is this house just cursed?
Ramsay Snow is a bloody savage. He shames the entire North.
Yet we're bound by law to obey him.
By the gods, I miss the Starks. The Glenmore Guard are gone. Ordered home by Ramsay. So much for having allies.
Ramsay says he's not taking sides anymore. He means to let the strongest house survive.
I intend that to be us, Duncan.
But can we even fight them? We don't have the numbers. We don't yet have Ryan back.
Right now, everything depends on Asher. Once he and Malcolm bring us more fighting men, then
where is he? Where is my brother?
My lady. My lady.
Let me through!
Elena.
Roderick, tell me where he... Oh! No! No! Oh, no! No! Arthur, no! Arthur! It's my fault. I brought him into this. I asked him to help. He did this for me!
You
can't blame yourself, Elena. He was a grown man. He made his own choices.
But he trusted me. He always has. I was there the day he learned to hold a bow. He was so nervous, the father called him Quiver. And now to die, like this, tortured, mutilated.
Ramsay Snow did this. He's a madman.
Ramsay was here because of you, Roderick. If we hadn't been your allies...
Elena.
I'm sorry.
Get you someplace warm.
How do I do this, Roderick? How do I keep going? Where do I find the strength?
You can't help the dead. So care for the living. For me, that's Ryan, Talia, Mira, and you.
Roderick. You've been such a friend to me, Roderick. Right from the very beginning. I should try to get some sleep. I'm not sure I'll be able to. But I don't know what else to do.
You're not alone, Elena. I'm here for you, whatever you need.
Thank you, Roderick.
You are. I haven't seen you since the coronation feast. How many ships do you suppose it takes to move an army?
Ships? Why in the world would you...
Never mind. Mira, I'll be honest. I took an enormous risk, defying Marjorie to get you into that feast, and you thanked me by making a scene with Lord Andros in front of everybody. Marjorie saw, of course, and she knew exactly how you got there.
Andros was the one doing the yelling. You can't blame me for his poor manners.
I'm sure you gave him good reason. Just as you do everyone. Marjorie included. Which is why it's not safe for me to be around you anymore.
What?
Mira, you're not the girl I knew at Highgarden. She'd never be so reckless. And now, with Garibald refusing to talk to me, I just can't risk being associated with you. Not anymore. Marjorie is my only protection without him.
That's fine by me. I don't need friends who get so easily overwhelmed.
It makes me sad to hear you talk like that. Was it worth it, at least? Sacrificing so much for your family.
Of course it was worth it. They're my family.
And they're very lucky to have you.
Thank you for your help. They'll be very grateful.
I better go before she sees me. She already...
Mira Forrester!
Can I help you?
You need to come with me. Now.
Why would I?
Don't make this difficult.
Come on, Beskar, listen. How can you still be angry at me?
Is that a joke? I had Dez Ozaraza in my hand and you made me let him go.
You know why.
Yeah, You were afraid of disobeying the pretty little queen. You chose your prize over my one chance of revenge. And for what?
Everything I do now, it's for my family.
Oh yes, those wonderful people who exiled you. You once said I was all the family you needed. We should never have come here. This city. It only holds pain for me, Yasha. I was hoping to bury it all with Dezor's corpse, but you denied me that. Please, I don't want to talk about it again.
Yasha, you're back.
Uncle. Let's collect our second sons and get out of here.
If you did as you were told, Daenerys should deliver.
Daenerys, huh? First names with the Queen now, are we?
Your Grace, my nephew has returned from his mission.
It seems you played your part in the taking of Meereen, Asha Forrester. Did you run into any trouble? Reports from the battle are muddled. Perhaps you can clear them up.
No battle is without difficulty, Your Grace. But we fulfilled your orders.
And for that, I am grateful. I hear you know how to follow orders, despite your friend's efforts to make you stray. You told me Asher was a man of integrity, Malcolm. Now I know you were telling the truth. You have proved yourself an honorable warrior. You have my gratitude. Unfortunately, I cannot spare my second sons.
What?
But Your Grace, the mission was a success.
I need every soldier to hold Meereen.
This is why you denied me my revenge?
You promised me Croft and his second sons.
Which is why I'm not going to let you leave here empty-handed. In truth, we are not so different. We're both far from home. We've both suffered the loss of those we've loved. And we both struggle to do what's right.
That's high praise, Your Grace. I'm honored.
You've earned it. I cannot give you my sellswords, but I will give you the next best thing. This gold will be of use. Perhaps you can find the swords you need in Meereen.
Thank you, Your Grace.
We promise to put it to good use.
I'm sure you will. A new day is born in Meereen. The slaves have thrown off their collars. There are fighters among those who used to be bound.
On behalf of the Forresters and the Branfields, I thank you.
See that you are ready when I return to Westeros. I have other plans for you, Malcolm.
Plans for me, Your Grace?
I have plans for my uncle as well.
I would like you to stay and serve me. I have a task for you.
Your Grace, I am humbled. But I owe my allegiance to my family.
And they will be grateful for the Targaryen alliance you've helped forge.
I am honored you would ask me. Might I discuss it with my nephew first?
Do so. But let me know your answer soon.
You'd seriously consider staying in Essos?
I'm not sure. This is all rather sudden. If she does come to Westeros, we'd want Daenerys Targaryen on our side. You've made a good start with her. I could strengthen that bond.
You're right, Uncle. The Mother of Dragons would make a powerful ally.
If she succeeds in taking the Iron Throne, she'll be the only ally we need. But whatever comes of this, we still need men who will fight for us now. The Queen thought we might find them here, among the newly freed.
The little Queen is right. Meereen holds plenty of killers, and I know the worst.
So what are we waiting for? Let's go get them.
I don't know, Asha. They're not like us. To them, killing is a sport. It's fun.
Let them have fun with the White Hills, then. As long as they kill them, I don't care.
Don't say I didn't warn you.
I must talk further with the Queen. Don't get yourselves killed.
So, where exactly are we going?
Well, these fighters used to be slaves. If I had to guess, I'd say they'll be trying to live like masters.
You're freezing.
Yeah, don't worry about it. Someone has to keep watch.
Oh.
It's getting worse, isn't it?
We're only about a few days out from the Antler River. We cross a bridge the first men built. And from there, we can try to find the North Grove. Right, Sylvie?
We're not going north. We're going south, to join Mance and the rest of the Free Folk.
But look...
That was always the plan, Cotter.
I have to go to the North Grove. My family's depending on it.
Your family needs you to wander around in the snow until you get eaten by a direwolf.
Please, Sylvie. He knows what he's doing.
Does he now? Tell me then. How did my brother get that gash in his arm? You dressed his wound up well enough. But why'd he get hurt in the first place?
What does that have to do with the...
Hush, Cotter! I'm asking Fishface here.
Sylvie!
Don't Sylvie me. I want to hear it from him.
Some wildlings. Free folk. Mistook Cotter for a crow.
Can't imagine why.
We tried to reason with them and, well, things got out of hand.
Out of hand? From the look of him, he was nearly killed. Point is, you don't belong out here.
Sylvie, I've known Gadded a while now. He may not be one of us, but I trust him.
I've been waiting months for you, Cotter, and when you finally come home, it's with some crow who can barely build a fire. No. We don't need to die for him.
Me neither. Fucking North Grove isn't even real. And if it is, it's probably full of wolves and more wildlings. Fens, probably.
It is real. Lord Forrester believed it. And so do I.
And you're both idiots.
Finn, will you
Just piss off!
Some leader you turned out to be.
You should listen to him. The further north you go, the more likely you'll never come back. It's just not worth it. Once Cotter's fit to travel, we head south. With or without you, Garrod.
Sylvie.
You need to rest. And we'll be wanting more than onions to eat. I won't go far.
Oh, don't be angry, Garrod. This isn't what it looks like. I can explain.
First I find out you're a wildling. Now you've got a sister. What else are you hiding?
Nothing. I swear. I thought she could help. Sylvie knows these woods better than I do. If anyone can find the North Grove, it's her. And besides... I couldn't just leave her. I won't do that. Not again.
Then convince her to go with us. She's your sister.
Well, maybe she's right. Maybe you don't belong up here.
You don't mean that. So that's it. I can't head north without a guide.
I go where she goes. I'm sorry, Garrod.
these unloyal motherfuckers. God damn it. Can't trust anyone in this fucking camp. Let's go after this girl. See what we can do. See what Finn has to say.
What are you doing over here? It's a perfectly good fire.
I'm not going anywhere near those fucking wildlings.
Oh, come on. Just give them a chance.
I did. And look where it got us.
I'm sorry for getting you into this mess. Really.
Not your fault. I wanted to come. Just didn't know this is how it turned out.
Come on, Finn.
You'll freeze your ass off if you stay here.
Suppose you're right. May as well get warm before I die.
Could you have been any louder?
Sorry.
Never met a crow before. Sorry I almost killed you. Might have done you a favor, though. Plenty of things want to kill a crow up north. Giants, fens, shadow cats and ice spiders. And the White Walkers, of course. A spear sounds nice after all that, doesn't it?
They can try to kill me if they want. I won't let them.
I'm sorry, but that's the dumbest thing I've ever heard. Don't frighten our dinner away. Shit.
My turn.
It's my turn.
Oh, really? You even know how to use that thing? You're not going to shoot me in the leg, are you?
I may do all right.
Just be sure to keep it aimed that way.
Bullseye!
That's better than making do. You're not a bad shot.
Well, I played a lot of Call of Duty and...
You'll do nicely, little one. So.
Would that be enough?
You ever seen Cotter eat? We'll need another. Come on.
Ah, damn it.
Ah, you're joking.
Maybe next time, Garrod. It's not much, but it'll last us. Cooked up with some of those onions you've got, we might even enjoy it. You're not half bad with a bow. Could come in handy. You ever lost anyone, Garrod? Someone you really cared about? Someone you... thought you couldn't live without seeing ever again. Do you know what that's like?
I lost my family. First my mother, then my sister and father.
So you know how it feels. Cotter and I, we lost everything too. And we nearly lost each other. I didn't think he'd make it back this time. And I won't risk losing him again. Not even for the North Grove.
You know something about it, don't you?
Only what I've heard. But don't get your hopes up. It's not worth it.
Do you know where it is, then?
I know where they say it is, but you'd be mad to try and go there.
Why is that?
A few years back, one of the Ice River clans set out to find it. They'd heard stories that the cold couldn't touch it, that it's safe even in the dark of winter. So they'd set out, all full of hope, and none of them ever returned.
Do you believe the stories?
Oh, I forgot. You Southerners don't believe in anything you can't see with your own.
Garrod!
motherfucker.
This looks like the place.
That was a surprise.
This is definitely the place.
So, who are we dealing with exactly?
Pit fighters. Two go in, one comes out. Day after day. No rules, but kill. Anyone who can survive that is capable of anything. They're crazed savages. But one pit fighter is worth any 10 cell swords. If you can convince them to fight for you. And that's not going to be easy. Don't expect to charm them or reason with them.
I've been fighting alongside cell swords for years, Beska. I know how to talk to killers.
Understand, these aren't soldiers. They're animals you unleash.
Well, this is a little bit macabre. Yeah, dear.
Must make you feel pretty good, seeing the masters overthrown.
They're not gone. They're just on their knees. And when they get back to their feet, they'll be more dangerous than ever.
You did what?
What the fuck?
Trust me, you don't want to get involved, Russia.
Well, that was fucked up.
Your friends have been busy.
Let's hope our heads don't end up here. Oh, one last thing. They're not fond of strangers. Or anyone who shows weakness. Or fear. Or really any highborn pricks with lily white arses like you, little brother.
I can handle this.
Oh, after you then.
Well, if it isn't Beska, the fucking basilisk.
We just want to talk to Amaya.
You don't want to be in here, little man. You best go back the way you came before I decide to eat you. I'll start with your eyeballs. Fucking juicy when they pop.
You sure you have room for me? You seem pretty well fed already.
My master only ever fed me when I won. I won a lot. Now, you've got to the count of three to turn around and walk away. One. I like this one. Hey, Amaya!
He's weird.
Company!
Is that a pit?
Yeah, some masters couldn't get enough of the fighting, so they built their own private pits. Where things could get really nasty.
That's Amaya.
Keep your cock in your pants, little brother. She's likely to chop it off.
Well, hello there.
Not many people get past the beast. You must need something very badly.
So, out with it. Before I decide not to let you leave.
My name is Asher Forrester. I've traveled all the way from Westeros.
I'd suggest you go back there. It's not safe here for outsiders.
Amaya, please.
Please what? I had a friend once, the Basilisk, but she died a long time ago.
I earned my freedom.
You walked out on me. On all of us. Fighting side by side, we were goddesses of the pits.
You have a problem with her? Deal with me.
So, what is it that you want? Why shouldn't we rip you to pieces and feed you to the beast? My patience wears thin.
Sail with me to Westeros and do to my enemies what you do best. Slay them all and lay waste to their lands!
You think we sell swords? We don't fight other people's wars. We are pit fighters! Artists who paint in blood!
That was yesterday. The fighting pits have been closed.
You're all free now! Free to do what you want!
Don't you see that?
Yes, we are free. Why would we follow another? We don't have masters anymore! Why would we follow anyone ever again?
I'll make you all rich! Your masters, they used you. They made gold from your blood. But I am offering you a chance to earn for yourselves.
Amaya, trust me. He's got enough gold for all of you.
You want to lead pit fighters? You have to earn their respect first.
We don't know who you are until we see you bleed.
You're gonna have to show them you can fight.
All right. Who? Who's the best you've got?
His name is Bloodsong. He's vicious, fearless, and fast.
I've never seen him before.
Take a good look there.
He's the man who's going to kill your boy.
And if I beat him, you and your men will join me in my fight.
If you can beat Bloodsong, you'll gain our respect. But no one has ever beat him.
Right. Well, suppose I better get this over with.
So what are you supposed to be? With your little axe and your pretty blonde beard? I'd sooner bend you over to fuck than fight you.
Thanks for noticing the beard.
Well, come on! Let's see how you die!
If I die in there...
Yeah? You have a dying wish? This ought to be good.
Will you return to Westeros and kill as many White Hills as you can?
No. I'll spend all your gold on the finest of whores.
Hey! I need those!
You'll fight with the weapons we give you.
You all see this cockless Westerosi? He's come to order us to battle, like our masters did. I kill no man because another orders me to. I kill a man because it pleases me! Let me show you how we dance in Meereen.
That's lovely. You know why I kill a man? So he's dead and I'm alive. Let's get this over with.
Choose a weapon and try not to die. Only one of you leaves the pit alive. May the best fighter win.
The best would be me.
Here, use this.
Are you ready? Westerosi! This is gonna hurt! Yours would be a beautiful death! Isn't that something you'd like to say? Hear that, boy? We cannot let the crowd go wanting!
I think I can, actually.
For that, you die slow.
That's no weapon worthy of Bloodsong!
See if you're still smiling after I break your face!
Surprised you can lift it.
Not so pretty anymore, huh?
Damn.
Last chance, Westerosi.
Would it help if I stood still?
Maybe.
Come on, pretty boy. At least...
Classic.
Champion is gone, as are your old masters. You can stay here in the ring with nothing, or you can come with me. I chose you for a reason. You're murderous scum, and murderous scum is just what I need. You deserve better than this. You deserve more than to die for someone else's entertainment. Fight with me, and you will have glory and gold! If you've got the balls to follow me, we will set sail at dawn, and to those too craven to join me, to hell with you!
Yeah, don't fuck with me, man. Oh shit, Walker.
I knew them!
What are those things? Oh, God! Over here! Over here!
anything could be killed!
Oh, shit.
Garrick!
Vic! Stay with me!
They run funny. Shit.
What's this about?
Your Grace. You're familiar with my brother's chambers, aren't you? Certainly you've been here before. You looked rather confused when you came in.
Yes, Your Grace.
I'd like to think we can be honest with one another. However, you're quite the curiosity, aren't you? You profess to be loyal to the Crown, yet you're not very loyal to Lady Marjorie.
Have I displeased you, Your Grace?
I've heard things. I understand you've been quite busy. Tell me, do you consider yourself an honest, loyal handmaiden? One can never tell with you northern girls. Assuming an honest person exists in King's Landing.
It hasn't been easy, Your Grace, but I've done what I've needed to do.
Haven't we all? I've done my best to keep an open mind about people like you. Yet, Lucan tells me you invited yourself to Tommen's coronation party. How exactly did that happen? It can't have been easy.
I do what's necessary, Your Grace.
Including using another girl to talk your way in, I'm told. You're not above using people to get what you want. Good. Why would you be so reckless as to risk your neck for what? It all seems rather careless, considering the consequences.
My family is still very much at risk, Your Grace. It was crucial I attend.
Your family. Sometimes that's a convenient lie we tell ourselves. When I suspect your issue with Lord Andros played a part in it. You've been such a busy little handmaiden. I assume Lady Marjorie knew nothing of this.
No, Your Grace.
This wasn't the first time you've hidden the truth from her. You've no qualms about lying to her, have you? Tell me the truth. Your secret is safe with me.
Only when I must, Your Grace.
I think we both know it's more often than that. Perhaps I mistook your northern stubbornness for ignorance, but now I see there's more to you. You're a cunning girl, and perhaps you can help me.
Your Grace?
You're quite friendly with my brother Tyrion. I need you to speak with him before the trial begins. I want to know who he intends to call as a witness on his behalf. Consider it a favor to the crown, for which we will all be grateful.
I guess I could, Your Grace.
It won't be easy. Tyrion is devious. You'll have to hide your intentions, otherwise he'll tell you nothing. You may prove to be a useful little bird to me, assuming you do as you're told. In return, I'll take care of your problem with Lord Andros.
Thank you, Your Grace.
I never liked the man anyway, and I doubt anyone will miss him.
Dealing with the devil. Fuck.
You think we hired this boat for nothing?
No, I don't know. That was a rousing speech you gave, little brother. But who knows how much they heard. Ever since you left me to that dragon, I've given a lot of thought to staying here. Leaving you to your Westeros and your foresters.
You have?
I was angry. But you're my family. No matter what. I'd follow you anywhere, little brother. Just try not to get us killed.
Think we'd let you live without us, Westerosi?
They say your homeland is fat and prosperous. An orchard ripe for plucking.
We'll take what we want and kill anyone who stands in our way.
There's no spoils without victory.
Don't worry about that. Victory is all we know.
I'll show them their beds.
Vesco wasn't exaggerating.
Malcolm, you're here!
And you've found your soldiers.
Ironwrath will be glad of your return. You came through for them.
Just as I knew you would.
What should I tell Roderick?
Tell him what I do. I do for our house. Daenerys will eventually return to Westeros. If I can, I'd like to help her reclaim the Iron Throne. Imagine what an ally she'd be to House Forrester if she succeeds. Living here has made a better man of you, nephew. Perhaps the same will be true for me. You are your father's son, Asher. For all your differences, he would be proud. I'll send a raven ahead to Ironwrath to let Roderick know you sail for Westeros. With, sellswords. My thoughts will be with you in the fight to come. Asher. Iron from ice.
Iron from ice.
Casting off!
Take this. It'll help loosen his tongue. But be careful. He's a tricky little bastard. If he figures out who sent you, he'll tell you nothing. I'll be listening to every word you say.
Oh, I ask for brawn, they send me a handmaiden. Well, you're here. You might as well come in. Let me guess. Your family is in grave danger, and you've come seeking my help?
Not that I'd be of much use to you.
As you can see, I'm at a bit of a disadvantage.
I thought we were friends, Lord Tyrion.
I thought so as well.
Yet, here you are. You brought wine. How thoughtful of you. And you didn't even have to hide it. Doesn't smell poisoned.
Poisoned?
Cersei would love nothing more than to save herself the trouble of a trial. You don't expect me to drink alone, do you? They never let anyone in to see me.
I suppose I'll have just a little.
Ah, true girl of the North. Some things are worth dying for. So, why are you here? It's rather unusual for a handmaiden to visit the Black Cells.
I've been worried about you, Lord Tyrion.
Oh, have you? You may be the only person in all of King's Landing who doesn't want to see my head on a spike. You and Podrick. I have to admit, I've always admired your honesty, but I suspect there's more to you than one might imagine. This is all a ruse, isn't it?
Sorry?
You're coming here. We both know you have an ulterior motive. You've come to set me free. It's the perfect plan. No one would suspect it of you.
I'm afraid not, unfortunately.
Unfortunate for us both. So, tell me. Cersei sent you, didn't she? I know I'm not wrong. The truth, Mira.
She left me no choice.
She never does. At least you had the courage to tell me the truth.
I told you not to run your mouth! Stupid girl.
Back off, Lucan!
Watch your tongue, girl!
We're not done talking, you imbecile. Give us a moment.
Imp.
Cunt.
What did my sister expect you would learn?
Who will testify on your behalf?
She's using you. And will continue to do so. Until you no longer prove useful.
I'm the one using her.
If that's what you think, then you're more foolish than I thought.
She's taking care of a problem for me.
Cersei is not someone to be trifled with. And what would Lady Marjorie make of your new friendship with my sister? I doubt she'd be pleased. Assuming she doesn't dismiss you immediately.
To be honest, I don't care what Lady Marjorie thinks of me.
I thought you were smarter than that. Without her protection, you're in a very precarious position.
What should I tell Cersei?
She knows the answer better than anyone. No one will testify for me. She's already seen to that. That is the truth of it.
She'll never believe that.
Then come up with something better. Tell her I intend to call Sansa, Varys, Jaime. Give her a list of names and be done with it.
Enough of this nonsense! You're wasting my time! Out! Now!
I wish you well, Lady Mira. Be careful who you trust.
Well, in Game of Thrones, trust no one.
Or you will lose your fucking head.
Must you leave?
Yeah,
sorry.
Boy.
Didn't mean to wake you.
You tapped that ass.
You didn't sleep, did you?
Neither did you.
We haven't slept much at all these last few weeks. I hope you don't have any regrets. About this. About us.
My only regret is what happened to your brother. If I'd only...
Please, let's not talk about Arthur. Not now. What will we do now? Now that we're... what we are.
We'll be married. and no one will be able to keep us apart. Not Griff, not his father, not Ramsay Snow.
I was hoping you'd say that.
Roderick? Oh, I'm sorry. I thought you were alone.
Good morning, Talia.
Hello, Elena. Oh, I didn't realise you two were...
Talia, can't you knock?
Sorry, I should have...
It's just, this is urgent, Roderick. And... It's all right. I can go. You two need to speak. I'll see you soon, I hope.
Worth it.
All right, then. I'm listening.
Last night, I couldn't... I was having nightmares. So I...
Go on, Talia.
I went back there. To the grove. And someone was there.
What do you mean?
Look.
This is a report. How many fighting men we have? Where Griff and the White Hill garrison are being held?
It even talks about Elena.
I know. It's everything. I couldn't believe it. If I hadn't seen it with my own eyes...
You said you saw someone. Who?
Someone we trusted.
Talia, I need to know who it was.
He's like family, Roderick. But it doesn't matter. He's a traitor. He endangered our house. You have to deal with him like you would any other man. I'm sure he had his reasons. But no reason is good enough.
It's your duty to tell me. And mine to pass judgment.
Just promise me you'll kill him, Roderick. Anyone who would betray us like this deserves to die. I'm asking you as your sister.
I give you my word, Talia. The traitor will get what he deserves. Now, tell me.
Come with me. He's in the Great Hall.
Go get the guards.
Hey, oh, my lord, you scared the bloody daylights out. What's that?
You tell me.
You don't scare me, Roderick. I've known you since you were a boy.
Start talking.
Yes, I have been working with the White Hills, but only because you stopped listening to reason.
Did I now?
You pushed me to this, Roderick. You brought it upon yourself.
Don't you dare start making excuses.
Excuses? Are you that naive? Look at you, Roderick. You're weak. You're weak. Just like Ethan was. Making Duncan his sentinel.
Ethan was a boy.
Ethan was a fool. And you've been making fool choices too since the day you crawled off that corpse cart. Taking Duncan to High Point when what you needed was an experienced soldier. Shying away at every turn from a war you know is coming. Hell, you even managed to get Arthur killed.
Enough, Roiland!
You've had every opportunity to save this family, but you've squandered them all. Your father would be ashamed.
So you turn your cloak?
That's your answer.
I'm not gonna stand by and watch you destroy this family. You're driving House Forrester the way of the Starks.
The only thing that matters is that you swore an oath for
me. I swore to your father. I'd swear to Asher if he were here. But you're a cripple who can barely hold a sword. Asher knows how to act.
Asher would cut your traitor heart out.
Oh, I don't doubt it. He has more balls than you ever will.
Roderick, it's Griff. He's gone.
Somebody set him free. Was this your doing?
They were going to ambush you at the trade. I just saved your life.
But Ryan...
Ryan, how could you?
This was his doing. Just sentence me and be done with it.
Roderick, you promised.
Kill me. And Asher dies too.
Please, Roderick.
What do you mean?
I know Lud's plans. Spare my life. And I'll tell you everything.
Perhaps we should hear him out.
He's only saying that to save himself.
You must decide, my lord.
You must be loving this, Duncan.
Believe me, I'm not. I'll spare your life. Now talk.
You're a bigger coward than he is.
Shut up, punk.
Mira cost Lud his army. He's desperate to strike back. He's going to ambush Asher the moment he makes landfall.
No!
You must protect Asher. Protect the true lord of this house.
Take this traitor away.
Get your hands off me!
What Roiland said. We have to warn Asher.
We can't, not if he's at sea.
My lord, what do we do?
Prepare the horses.
We're gonna defend my brother.
War is coming. War is eternal. I will fuck them up.
I swear to God, I will.
Fight for the sun! Hey ho, Northmen! Or fight for the riches in Ironborn!
You smell that? We're almost there, Beskar. Let's have a look.
Come on, break it up!
Save your lovemaking for below deck.
They listen to you. Barely. But what happens if your lord brother decides he's the one in charge once we're at Ironwrath? Do you expect them to follow his orders? Or will it be you commanding them? They don't know him. A lord sounds an awful lot like a master.
Doesn't matter if Roderick's lord of our house. These are my soldiers to lead.
Huh? You may want to start by telling them your brother's not to be harmed. He hasn't had a chance to win them over like you have.
Point taken. That's odd. Port's quiet. No guards. Hardly any ships.
Maybe they're all off fighting one of your king's wars.
Could be.
Or could be we'll have a fight on our hands. I'll let the others know.
Right. Oh, this couldn't be easy, could it?
Never is.
So, this is Westeros.
Ugly and small.
Fucking freezing, too.
I said you'd be paid. I never said you'd be warm.
Asher. Thank the gods you've made it back.
Good to see you, my lord.
Hope you're ready for a fight.
Lord knows you're coming. He sent men to intercept you. We need to hurry.
Been stuck on a boat for weeks. Could use a good fight.
What?
Get that gate open!
Asher, no!
Destroy them! It's been a while since I killed any Wyhills.
Oh yeah, eat that, bitch.
Oh shit.
Out of my way! It won't go further!
Asher, you have to get out of there!
Looks like it's up to us!
Fuck.
Asher! Raise the gate! They've got us outnumbered!
Oh, shit!
We have to get out of here!
Holding it. One of us has to stay.
My lord, you must hurry. We can't lose you.
Let me save your life and our house.
Iron from ice, brother.
Iron from ice. I'll hold them off!
But my lord, you can't!
Asher is your new lord.
Yes, my lord.
Roderick!
Go!
This ain't that Game of Thrones without killing a lot of major characters. Oh well, guys, thank you for watching me, and I'll see you back again on the episode 6.